स्टूडेंट टुडे दिस इज़ द सेकेंड लेक्चर ऑफ द मिनरल एंड एनर्जी रिसोर्सेज। टुडे वी विल स्टडी डिफरेंट टॉपिक्स सच एज क्लासिफिकेशन ऑफ रिसोर्सेज, डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन ऑफ रिसोर्सेज एंड मोड ऑफ अकरेंस ऑफ मिनरल्स। सो इन द फर्स्ट स्टूडेंट वी विल डिस्कस द टॉपिक क्लासिफिकेशन ऑफ मिनरल्स। सो स्टूडेंट मिनरल्स हैज़ बीन क्लासिफाइड इन टू द डिफरेंट कैटेगरी एज यू विल सी। दीज आर द मेटेलिक मिनरल्स, नॉट मेटेलिक मिनरल्स and energy resources. Metallic minerals, which is classified into the three categories, ferrous, non-ferrous and precious minerals. Ferrous minerals means iron ore, manganese, nickel, cobalt, means there is the kind of proportion of the iron is found there. Non-ferrous minerals means the kind of mineral where the iron is not found there, copper, lead, tin and so many other minerals. Precious mineral means the minerals which are more and more expensive, such as gold, silver and platinum and so many others. Second category of the minerals is non-metallic minerals, such as mica, salt, potash, sulfur, granite and so many other minerals, means which are not have any kind of the solidness or any kind of the brightness or any kind of the ductileness, the minerals. Third category of the minerals is energy minerals, such as the coal, petroleum, natural gas. These minerals have the potential to produce the energy, so that they are very very productive for the running of energy, for running of the machineries, industries and so many other things. Our second topic is distribution of minerals. As a student you know very well, the minerals which are found in the country in so many specific forms. You will see that in the first, the minerals which are found there, the northern parts, especially the western northern part, where the non-ferrous minerals is found there, especially the copper. Second is the non-minerals area, or the area where the minerals are not found there, means the area where the divide of minerals. Why the minerals are not found there, I will tell you. Second, the places you will see there in the map, the petroleum which are found in the western part of India and eastern part of India. And you will see the Deccan Plateau, where you will see the some metallic minerals and some not metallic minerals, mica, coal and so many other minerals. This region is known as the Peninsular India. It is also known as the powerhouse of the energy. Why the metallic minerals are found there, why the not metallic minerals are found there, and why the northern part of India have not any kind of the minerals availability, the region. Actually the reason is that the northern part of India, which is very new forms of the land of earth, especially in India. So this part is only the 20 lakhs years ago, means when the mountain of the Himalayas were formed, the same period this area of the land was formed due to the alluvial process, due to the decomposition, due to the sedimentation, this is a land of the India was formed. So this is a new form of land, and you know very well the minerals are found on that area, on that land forms where the land are very very more old. So in this area the minerals are formed there. The student will see the petroleum, the mica, the coal, the iron minerals are found there in the peninsular region, especially in the Deccan Plateau, where the minerals is found there because due to the region, the area is known as a Gondwana land, and Gondwana land is the very more old land. You know very well the earth was made from the different tectonic plates, and in this area the old tectonic plates are found there. Petroleum is found in the western part of India and eastern part of India. The reason is that in this region the known porous rocks are found, with the porous rocks due to the region the minerals are found there in this category, in these forms. I hope all the students could understand well. Student, next topic is minerals and energy resources, where we will study the mode of occurrence of the minerals, means where the minerals are found, in which category, in which forms, what are the possibilities of the minerals availabilities, and in which type of the rocks. We will see this topic one by one. So student, in the first I will tell you, the minerals are found in the different five forms: igneous and metamorphic rocks. Second is सेडिमेंट्री रॉक्स, नेक्स्ट इज रेजिडुअल मास ऑफ द वेदर्ड मटेरियल, एल्यूवियल डिपॉजिट्स एंड लास्ट वन इज ओशन वाटर। तो स्टूडेंट यू विल सी दैट मोर ऑफ अक्रेंस ऑफ मिनरल्स वेयर द इग्नियस एंड मेटामॉर्फिक रॉक्स वेयर द मिनरल्स आर फॉर्म देयर। इन द स्टूडेंट यू विल सी दैट दिस इज द अर्थ एंड दिस इज द रेड पार्ट इज नोन एज द मेंटल पार्ट एंड मेंटल पार्ट यू नो वेरी वेल इट इज द वेरी मोल्टन पार्ट ऑफ द अर्थ। इन दिस मोल्टन पार्ट यू विल सी दैट इन दिस पार्ट द मोल्टन फॉर्म्स द रॉक्स आर फाउंड देयर ड्यू टू द लॉट ऑफ प्रेशर ड्यू टू द लॉट ऑफ लिक्विड एंड गैसेज फॉर्म ऑफ द मिनरल्स विच इज प्रेशराइज फ्रॉम द डाउन साइड टू अपवर्ड्स एंड यू नो दैट दीज आर द काइंड ऑफ क्रैक्स जॉइंट एंड क्रेविसीज एंड यू विल सी दैट इन दिस एरिया वेन द मोल्टन रॉक्स फोर्स्ड अपवर्ड्स ड्यू टू द लॉट ऑफ प्रेशर सो दीज मोल्टन रॉक्स इज फिल्ड इन दिस एरिया वेयर देर इज ए गैप वेयर इज ए जॉइंट वेयर देर इज ए काइंड ऑफ फॉल्ट इन दिस रीजन वेयर द मोल्टन रॉक्स हैज़ बीन फॉर्म्ड हैज़ बीन फिल्ड इन दिस एरिया एंड दीज आर द स्मॉल अक्रेंस एंड दीज आर द बिगर अक्रेंस स्मॉल अक्रेंस आर नोन एज ए वेंस एंड बिगर अक्रेंस आर नोन एज ए लोड्स बिकॉज इन दिस एरिया द स्मॉल टाइप ऑफ द जॉइंट स्मॉल टाइप ऑफ द फॉल्ट आर देयर सो स्मॉल कैटेगरीज ऑफ द मिनरल्स कैन बी फिल्ड देयर एंड दीज आर द बिग एरियाज वेयर द मिनरल्स आर बीन फॉर्म देयर सो मोल्टन लिक्विड एंड गैसेज फॉर्म ऑफ द मिनरल्स फोर्स्ड अपवर्ड्स टूवर्ड्स कैविटीज अर्थ क्रस्ट एंड स्टोर देयर व्हेन दे बिकम कोल्ड और कूलीफाई सो वी विल डग आउट एंड वी विल फाइंड द मिनरल्स। अवर सेकेंड कैटेगरी ऑफ द मिनरल्स अक्रेंस इन द सेडिमेंट्री रॉक्स यू विल सी दैट इन दिस एरिया द मिनरल्स आर फाउंड देयर। एक्चुअली द रीजन इज दैट इन दिस रीजन द लॉट ऑफ विल से सेडिमेंटेशन विच इज़ प्रोसेस्ड ड्यू टू द मिलियंस ऑफ ईयर्स इन द अर्थ एंड इन द फॉर्म ऑफ रिमेन्स ऑफ द एनिमल्स रिमेन्स ऑफ द प्लांट्स रिमेन्स ऑफ द मेनी ऑफ द अदर यू विल से materials or the living forms so these sedimentation is stored there for the long of process and deposition accumulation and concentration process due to the lot of years millions of years these minerals has been stored there and these is found in the very below of the earth so we will dig out these minerals through this tunnel and we will make the minerals in the form of we'll say long tubes and these long tubes are known as a long tunnels in the earth in the we'll say horizontal order and we will find the minerals such as coal gypsum potash and so many other minerals. Next category of the minerals is residual mass of the weathered material. Actually the reason is that you will see that these are the area of the earth is made from the porous rocks and this area of the earth is made from the non-porous rocks. So in this area the region where the minerals which are formed there due to the long process because many of the you will say decomposition material stored there for a long process and due to the porous rocks the water which is flow through there and weathered material also flow through there but the minerals is stored for a long time long process millions of years so this region where we will find the minerals because these porous rocks flow throughout the time throughout the years in the you will say millions of years and non-porous rocks is not disturbed so we will find the minerals actually in this region we will find the bauxite type of the minerals and these minerals are found in the sponge plateau. Sponge plateau means the kind of plateaus which store the water due to the non-porous rocks and the bottom layer of the area which is made by the non-porous rocks so they support to store the minerals for a long time. So leaving a residual masses of the weathered materials we will find the minerals because these layers containing the ores I have told you the region because decomposed surface rocks and the removal of soluble constant which is stored there for a long times and we will find the non-porous rocks the materials, the minerals. Alluvial deposit, we will find the minerals such as the hilly regions where the river water which is carrying the lot of deposit, lot of material. These material flow through the rivers at the bottom level, at the hill stops of the mountains of the Himalayas or the many of the other mountains. These minerals deposited in layers and also called the placer deposit. So these minerals store there, and these are minerals are not corroded by the water. So such minerals can be found there, which cannot be corroded by the water, such as gold, silver, tin. So through the erosional activities of the rivers that deposit in the layers and placer. So this minerals also known as the minerals which are found in the layers or in the placer deposit. And last one, the mode of occurrence of the minerals is ocean water, which is dissolving the minerals with the water are found there in the ocean beds. These minerals are known as the salt, magnesium, bromide and many other forms of the minerals. But we have dug out the minerals, we have mined the minerals from the ocean very limited amount because we have not the developed technology. I hope all the students could understand well. So please take the study from the book and study it continuously, this topic. And I hope all the students could understand well. Thank you.